thanks for coming on Sirajology.
That's a great name.
Sirajology is a great name. I appreciate it. Yeah, so like, how's life? How's everything going lately?
Life is pretty good, actually. Living in San Francisco, which is one of my favorite cities in the world. New York is a very close second, I think. Actually, they might be tied. Love my job, love my apartment, love my pet snake.
You have a pet snake?
Yeah, I have a pet snake.
What is the pet snake's name?
His name is Hiss, which is not a very good name because he doesn't actually hiss.
What's his pet name?
He's like super chill.
He's super chill, yeah. Okay. Is he a killer snake?
No, he eats frozen mice.
Do you have mice in the apartment?
In the freezer, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
What got you to start working at BitTorrent?
A recruiter found me online almost 2.5 years ago when I first started working there. And I don't even think I realized at the time that it was a company. I had used their protocol and their client application, especially in college, to download music and stuff, for a college student. He reached out to me and said they were looking for a front-end engineer on a particular project, and I just got really, really excited. I felt like there was definitely something incredibly special about the folks at BitTorrent. It's just like a bunch of quirky nerds who just love technology and love what they do, and nobody's really trying to show off or, be trendy or, they're in it for the right reasons, and I just felt really at home there.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And it's cool that, like, through this period of, like, job hunting, which can be really hard, you found a great position that you seem to love.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's great.
Like, I personally, I was looking for jobs, and I got rejected by a lot of places.
Yeah.
And it hurts a lot. I mean, do you have any kind of advice for people who are looking for tech jobs, like how to deal with rejections and what did you do?
Oh well, definitely crying in the shower.
Okay.
That helps a lot. No, seriously though, rejection is definitely gonna happen, and it hurts and it sucks, and there's really nothing you can do about it. But usually, you'll find after the initial period of being upset that it's usually it's like kind of a blessing in disguise. You usually realize that that was not the right place to be working. It might not have been the right fit, or if somebody doesn't want you working there, that's not really, it's you don't want to date someone who doesn't want to date you. I think the key is just to keep powering through and just to not let it get you down too much, because eventually you do find the right thing.
For sure. I think that's a great analogy, the dating thing. You don't want to date someone who doesn't want to date you. What's your day-to-day life at working at? Because it's an open source protocol, right?
Yeah.
But it's a company
that
has money.
Right. We have multiple products as well. It's not just the what we call the BitTorrent client. So I work on the browser team.
Okay.
I'm a front-end engineer.
Maelstrom,
yeah. Although we're actually rebranding this spring as Surf.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it's going to be super sexy.
Oh, yes.
I'm a front-end engineer, but I occasionally work in the back end. So it's basically BitTorrent, but in the Chromium browser. So we've taken the Chromium open source code, and we've inserted some of our BitTorrent stuff in there, and now you can basically enter a magnet link and get a torrent right in your browser.
That's awesome. Is it challenging, or do you feel like it's something very doable?
Well, both.
Both.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, which is part of why I love my job. Some things are just super easy, where it's doing some kind of UI work that's just very straightforward and simple. And then sometimes, actually, the thing I did today was going in and trying to change, trying to get our torrent settings link into the Chromium menu. The drop-down menu.
Oh, okay.
And you think that would be really straightforward, except the Chromium code is not. So it's basically like a treasure hunt, and you're trying to figure out where in the code you actually have to change something. So it's really challenging, but it's also really fun, and it's doable, and it usually feels good when you actually figure out how to do something.
Yeah. What got you into programming in general?
So I moved to California, to San Francisco in 2005, and I was actually an astrophysics major in university.
Whoa.
So, yeah. So, but I didn't want to go into research or academia. And so when I moved out here, I was planning on going back to school for, mechanical engineering or something a little bit more applied. And while I was doing that, I had a couple friends who were working on some random project that involve programming. They wanted to make some, actually YouTube visualizations.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah, and so I said, you know, what the hell, I'm gonna learn how to program and I'll see if I can help out. And then I just sort of never looked back, I've just been programming ever since.
That's awesome. And one of, I think one of the sad things about Silicon Valley is there's not enough women in programming.
Yeah.
It's awesome that you are. Do you have any like advice that you would give to like girls who want to learn to code or, you know, they want to get into the field?
Yeah, definitely. I would definitely say that first you have to sort of find something that you want to build or make or just something that you're curious about. It doesn't have to be good, it doesn't have to be, you know, useful. It can even be something that someone did already that you want to learn about, so you just want to rebuild it on your own or something. But it has to be something you're interested in and somewhat passionate about, and then you just sort of have to go for it. The other bit of advice would be to not let anyone tell you that you can't do something, or let anyone put you down. And if people do, because you will definitely encounter people who are really insecure themselves and want to put others down and make them feel stupid and make them feel bad. And so just find any way to not let that bother you.
Absolutely.
Because that's huge. I went into an interview once, I definitely won't say where, and you could tell the guy who came into the room didn't know that I was a woman from my resume, and he took one look at me and you could just see the look on his face, like, it was just immediately, like, it went from, like, friendly to condescending in, like, under a second. Obviously, I can't prove that it was because I'm a woman, but,
right, definitely because you're a woman.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow, okay. What would be, like, an ideal, you know, 10 years from now for you, like for your future, or?
Well, hopefully there's a cute guy involved in the picture.
Oh, yeah. That'd be cool.
In terms of career.
For sure, yeah. Absolutely.
I'd like to see myself doing something, maybe a little more science or physics oriented. I don't know exactly what that would be, but I actually really miss science, and so if I can figure out a way to combine the two,
like without programming.
Yeah, without necessarily needing like a PhD in physics, because I think a lot of, you know, if I wanted to go work at SpaceX or something, I pretty much need a PhD.
Yeah.
So yeah, trying to find something along those lines where I can still keep up with those interests.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, I think thanks for answering all these questions. Thanks for coming.
Thank you for having me. This was so fun.